Yes, today I'll be talking about my lizards and just like how to sex them and just like lizard care and breed. The enclosure will be in the next video, and there are stories of how I caught them in the next video. But first up, this is Cleo. These are western fence lizards. Cleo is a girl. Yeah, she does have some red in her back. Don't know what's up with that. She's my cute little girl. When I sex them, I'll show you, but that's Cleo. And I do not know their age because they're not they weren't grown captive. This is Lilo. I know she is darker. That's kind of how she always is. Even in the light. That's Lilo. She had a little injury. Not while I caught her, but not while I owned her. Well, I don't own them, but you get the point. I'm gonna set her down. There you go. And here's Kona. Her tail came off, but that was because I had to catch her. So she is up. She is the same breed as the other lizards. She was dark at one point, and it's just she's been light ever since I caught her. So, and then I'll grab scales. Let me just put her down. Grab him. Hold on. I had them in this right now. This is not a suitable cage. I'll talk about that in the next video. This is Scales. He's the youngest. He's the only male. You can see it in just like his top scales. I know the name isn't the most creative, but it's what I had at the time. Now it's stuck with him. So, how to sex the females and the males is here. Cleo is a good example of a female. Let's see if I can catch her. I'm gonna show her belly. You can see there's not a lot of color. Okay, that wasn't very long. Here, let me see if I can get it. It's wobbling. This is Cleo. Let's see if I can get her turned over. Here we go. You can see she's got a little bit of color, but not much on there. And if you look closely, will it focus? Okay, you can kind of see it. There's one. It's right here, okay. Here, let's wait for it to focus. You can kind of see it. There's not like a too large circular scales. And on. Let me see if I can get him on his belly. Okay, hold on. Let me try that again. Here you can see a bit. He's got that dark blue there. And on the neck too, and it's just darker. Let me see if I can show you the here. Okay, well, hold on, let me grab him. See if I can show you guys. Here, you can't see it. No. What if I hold it back? No. You can kind of see there are two circular scales. Those indicate male. If your lizard does not have those, then it's a female. And, most of the female fence lizards don't have color, but some do, including Kona and Lilo. Here, let's see if I can get them flipped over. See, she's got a bit of color, But there's not as much black. Let's see if I can move her hand. You can still kind of see in her neck. It's just more white. There's not as much black part. Lilo, I was really confused for a while. I haven't looked at her belly in a while. And usually the males are just like a bit darker than usual, like scales is. Kind of see. And it was darker, but she is a she. And so that's how you sex them. And you can really see in his back too. And they change color. Like when your lizard changes color, it's like they've not been in the light long enough, or if your lizard is all dark or like darker than Lilo is, that's a sign. It's not camouflage. I thought that for a really long time. It's actually it's like how they adapt. Like if they're too cold, they turn black, and then they use that to absorb heat better, which is really smart. And Cleo has like a red brown. They can do that sometimes. So it's important that they have their heat lamp. What else was I gonna talk about? Oh, right. So her tail came off. Luckily, it was kind of far down. You can see the little stub there. That's after like, what, a month? A few weeks after the tail coming off. So it's starting to grow back, which is really good. And actually, it's growing back pretty fast. When you pick them up, some of them will like hop off. And like Cleo and Scales, they don't necessarily like to be picked up. Well, that was nice. They don't necessarily like to be picked up, but Scales, sometimes it's harder to get them off of your hand. Just have to go with another hand, try to get them, and then just put them down. And I like to train my lizards to be calmer, but you see, Cleo just dig down right now. Oh, there she goes. Yep. They sleep like that. They sleep in, like, digging in the dirt. I don't know what it does, but it keeps them warm, everything. And what else is there to talk about? Oh, if the lizard's tail comes off, you want to keep them in a very clean environment for a few days while it like scabs up, because you don't want like dirt getting into the cut part and get that getting infected. So that's just bad. You want to make sure they're in a clean environment. Or if like their scales are like cut open, like if there's a cut and you can like see veins and stuff, you want to make sure the lizard is in a very clean environment until it starts to scab. But of course you cannot keep them in there for like over 3 or 4 days, because it will slowly drive them insane, because they need digging stuff. This is what I used for like a little quarantine. Of course it had more wood, like basking wood and stuff in it, and didn't have dirt there. It was just paper towels, but that will slowly drive them insane because they need to dig to sleep. It's like if someone didn't give you a bed or a blanket for a few days, you'd slowly, well, it would be very unpleasant, so you only do that for a few days. I didn't, for Lilo, I did her for 2 days. She had a little cut on her arm. I didn't cause it, I swear, it was from kids at school. But, so that's pretty much it on, like, the lizard itself. I'll talk about cage interior stuff in the next video.